This video is part of my Udemy courses. See the description for more info. Hey there! In this lecture, we're gonna look at the basics of coding in GameMaker language. In the previous lecture, we had a look at events and we learned that an event contains code that runs when the event runs. So now let's see how code inside an event works. Let's go back into our project, and here in the object, let's go into the create event. Here you're gonna see a line at the top where you can enter the description for this event, and that will appear here in the events window. After that line, you have all the other lines to yourself to write any code you want. Now coding is all about giving commands to the computer, and in coding, a single command is known as a statement. So I'll enter a simple statement here. This is setting the x coordinate of the instance to 0. So this is a statement, a command given to the computer to set x to 0. Now a statement can be ended with a semicolon, and this is now a complete statement. In GameMaker, you don't need to have a semicolon at the end of a statement, and it is completely optional in this language. So this also works fine, but I recommend using a semicolon because while it may be optional in GameMaker, it's not optional in many other languages. So you should learn to use semicolons properly. Now this is a variable, and in this statement, you're assigning a value to a variable. So this kind of statement is a variable assignment. We are going to expand on variables in the next section. Now I'm gonna show you a different kind of statement. This is a function which is called instance_destroy. A function is like its own command that does a specific thing. In this case, this function is going to destroy the instance and remove it from the room. Instance destroy is just the name of the function, and we are running that function using these parentheses at the end. So this is a function call statement because we are simply running or calling a function. Let's add a semicolon at the end of this statement as well. And this is basically what coding is about. It's about writing statements, whether you're assigning a value to a variable or running a function or doing something else. Now in the next section, we are gonna have an in-depth look at functions and the other parts of GameMaker language. Hey there! In this lecture, we are gonna look at functions and how they are used. Functions are quite common in programming, and it's how you get things done. For example, in a game, you would use functions to create a new enemy, to destroy an enemy, to restart the level, to go to the next level, and so on. There are a lot of functions that exist in GML to do these sorts of things, and we're gonna take a look at some of them in this lecture. Let's open our project and go into Oh My object. Let me remove this line from the create event, and now we're gonna use a function to destroy the instance that runs the function. I'm gonna do it in an event that runs when I click on the instance. So I'll go into add event, and here under mouse, you can see a lot of events related to the mouse buttons. I'm gonna use this left pressed event, which runs when I click on the instance. The left down event that you see here keeps running if you hold the mouse button. That's not something I need, so I'm gonna use this left pressed event, which runs only on clicking. Once we have that event added, we are going to add some code to it. Here I'm going to call the instance destroy function, again with the parentheses at the end. This is gonna destroy the instance, and it'll happen when I click on it. So now I'll run the game to test our new event. I'll click on an instance, and you can see that it gets destroyed. So we have used a function to perform an action on an instance. Now we're gonna use a function to create a new instance of an object. But before doing that, I'm gonna import a new sprite and create a new object. So I'll go to Sprites and here create a new sprite asset. I'll name this as ship, and for this I'll import a ship sprite. For the origin, I'm gonna use middle center. Now I'll go into objects and here create a new object asset. I'll name this or ship, so this will be my new ship object. I'll quickly go into the properties and assign the sprite to it. Now we're gonna create an instance of this object, but not in the room editor. We're gonna do it in the game using a function. So let's go back to OhMyObject inside the left pressed event. Now the function that we're gonna use is called instanceCreateLayer. As the name says, this creates an instance on a layer. So it's the same thing that we do in the room editor, but we are doing it within the game using this function. I'm gonna write the parentheses at the end, and now you'll notice that here we have a warning. If you hover your cursor on it, you'll see that it basically says that the function requires 4 arguments. Now, what is an argument? An argument is any value that you give to a function, and you write those arguments inside these parentheses. So anything you enter here will be an argument. You can see exactly what arguments are required for this function by having your text cursor inside these parentheses and then looking at the bottom of the code window. Here you see the function name, and within these parentheses you see the required arguments. There are 4 arguments required for this function, which are x, y, layer, and object. The x and y are simply the coordinates where the new instance will be created. So for these arguments, we are gonna use the x and y of the current instance. So within the parentheses, I'll write this. Now we have entered 2 arguments here, separated by a comma. The x and the y where the new instance will be created will be at the position of the current instance. Now we are using the x and the y variables, but these arguments can also be any number values. Of course, we are gonna keep using x and y. Next, we need to write our third argument, so I'll add another comma. This argument is the layer ID or name, so this is the layer where the new instance will be created. If you go in the room editor, you'll see that our instance layer is simply called instances, and I'm going to create the new instance in this layer. I need to enter the layer's name in this argument, so if I do this, then it's not gonna work because the function is expecting a string. A string is just some text enclosed in double quotes, so I'm gonna place the quotes around this name. And this is how you tell the function the name of your layer. We are gonna expand on strings later in this section. Now let's come to our last argument, and for that, I'll add another comma. This argument is the object that we are creating an instance of, and since we wanna create an instance of OhShip, I'm gonna enter that. Now our function call is complete. You can see that the warning has also disappeared. A quick side note, you might be wondering why the object name is not inside quotes, and the reason for that is that the object is an asset, and assets are directly available in GML, so you don't have to enter them as strings, and you can mention them directly. The layer, however, is not an asset, so that's why it's entered as a string. Now, what's going to happen in this event is that the instance will be destroyed, and then a new instance will be created from the OhShip object. It'll be created at the same position as the current instance inside the instances layer. Let's run the game and see the effect of our new function calls. When I click on an instance, it gets destroyed and is replaced by an instance of OhShip. So that is happening because of the instance create layer function. But what that function does depends on its arguments. You can change the position, the layer, and the object, and depending on this data, the function will do something different. So that is the role of arguments in a function. Also, anytime you want to know more about a function, you can middle click on the function name, and that will open the GameMaker manual where you'll see an explanation of the function and all of its arguments. Now back to our object. This here is an event that doesn't run every frame. That's something we already know. It runs only when you click on the instance. So let's use a function that we're gonna run every frame, and we're gonna do that inside the draw event. So I'll go ahead and add that event. This event runs every frame, and here you can draw something on the instance using functions. Those functions will be called every frame, so that what you're drawing is actually visible on the screen. Our draw event is empty right now, so I'll run the game before writing any code here, and you'll notice that our instances are now invisible. You can't see them at all. This is happening because the draw event is empty. When you have an empty draw event, the instance itself isn't drawn as well. If you delete the draw event, of course you'll see the instance again. But to draw the instance in the draw event, you have to call the drawSelf function. If you run the game now, you'll see the instances again. So this is just something you have to remember to call when you're using the draw event so that the instance itself is actually drawn. Now we're gonna use a function to draw another sprite. So first I need to import a new sprite. The name for this will be shalo, and I'll import an image for it. I'll set the origin to middle center, and now our new sprite is ready. We don't have to create a new object for it because we're gonna draw the sprite itself in our first object. So I'll go back to the object, and here we're gonna use the drawSprite function. This also requires some arguments, such as the sprite that will be drawn, where it will be drawn, and so on. You can see them down here. First we have the sprite, so for that I'll enter shalo. Then we have the subimage, which is the frame that will be drawn. Our sprite is not an animation, so it only has one frame, and the number of that frame is 0, so I'll enter that. Then we have the X and the Y, where the sprite will be drawn. So for that, I'll again enter the X and the Y of the instance, and now this function call is complete. It should draw this sprite at this position. Let's run the game, and now you're gonna see the halo sprite being drawn on our instances. It's drawing too close to the instance, so I'll change the coordinates a little. I'll subtract 60 from the Y so that the halo is drawn above the instance. Now this doesn't actually change the Y position of the instance. It only affects the value that is being passed into the function. The Y of the instance remains the same. Let's run the game again, and now the halo is drawn above the instance. You can easily change where it's drawn by modifying the coordinates in this function. So now we have a basic understanding of what functions are and how they can be used. Of course, GML has a lot of functions, and as this course progresses, we are going to be using different kinds of functions and learning about the many ways that functions can be used. In the next lecture, we are going to be exploring variables and learning about another exciting feature of functions. So I'll see you there. I hope you enjoyed the video. You can watch more tutorials from here and make sure to subscribe for more GameMaker content. I'll see you in the next video.